say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home
That was Skylar Cole singing the national anthem, a fantastic rendition. Greetings, everyone. Welcome to 2K Sports and another exciting edition of NBA Basketball. With Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan. We'll be hearing from David Aldridge on the sideline. DA, it's all yours.
Well, guys, the Cavaliers are now a factor in the East. Jared Allen says, we want people to know they're going to have a fight on their hands. Over the past few years, it's been like, oh, it's the Cavs, it's an off night. But now we want people to look at us and say, we need to bring our A game. Kevin, consider that mission accomplished.
I agree. That's right, David. You're right on it. And thanks for the report. As the season rolls on, Brent, how do squads manage to preserve momentum and energy and keep themselves fired up?
Yeah, you got to challenge yourself, Kevin, to try to continue to be consistently good. And I think that's what you're talking about here is a standard with which you play is going to help you continue to get wins because you expect that from one another.
So here's Miami's starting group. At the guard spots, Lowry and Hero. Adebayo is out there with Martin, and it's Butler in at the three spot. And for the Cavaliers, in at small forward and power forward, it's Okoro and Mobley. Donovan Mitchell is out there with Darius Garland, and it's Allen in at the center. Now here's Butler, down low. Here's Adebayo, and it's sent back by Allen. Garland against Lowry. Mitchell a screen on Lowry. Garland the pass to Okoro. Mobley outside. Shot clock at 6. And here's Garland for 3. Rebound by the Heat.
And Garland, a finalist for Most Improved Player of the Year in 2022, took a huge leap forward with his play.
Now, Hero. Very solid contribution from him as he averages over 20 points a game. Right at the free throw line, and it's Butler missing. And so it's Mitchell who brings up the ball for the Cleveland Cavaliers. For Garland, he put in the work, and it all came together for him, GA.
His shooting reached a tipping point. What was given the keys as a playmaker, and this is a great situation for him. And boy, he's made the most of it.
Always fun to look at. Not tremendously efficient, but the floater, boy, those sure are pretty.
Here's Lowry. 11-point game, his last outing. Butler kicks to Lowry. Butler sets a screen for Lowry. And again, it's the Heat missing.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Passes it to Allen. Mitchell with it. Allen, a screen on Hero. The shot by Mitchell, no good. The Heat have gone 0 of 3 from the field to start the game. Butler passes to Hero. Over Mitchell. Miami, no good on that time either.
That's 0 for 4 now. Time to slow it down and maybe get the best possible shot the next time down.
He feeds it to Allen. lays it up and banks it in.
And getting a great look for the big guy as Allen scores on the interior.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game. And let's go down to a list of players you can't leave open under any circumstances. This season's most accurate small forwards from the field. Second, Jimmy Butler.
And that is such an efficient group offensively. That really is the best way to describe them. I mean, they never force anything and always wait for the right shot.
And when they get to those sweet spots, you can just count it. Each one of them is capable of having that kind of night where it looks like the bucket is about 5 feet wide for them. And for Miami, a tough way to go out last season. Game 7 at home against Boston. Jimmy Butler pulls up for a three and that close to the finals. Oh, that mid-range, Jay, usually pretty much on the money. Maybe the timing just a little bit off on that one.
For three, Mitchell nailed from three-point land. Mitchell's got his second bucket tonight.
And when he's hitting from deep, Mitchell's practically unguardable. Can't crowd him out there. He'll just drive right around you.
Three-pointer, Martin. Allen with the rebound. And Brent, even when playing catch-up, the Heat were maybe one shot away from heading to the finals for the second time in 3 years.
Yeah, lots of questions around that shot, Kevin, too, about whether Jimmy should have drove or shot it. And look, let Jimmy be Jimmy. He took the shot. He didn't make it. And so now it's about getting back on the grind and trying to get back there. This team has the mental toughness to put themselves in that position.
Scraping and clawing, doing everything he can to grow that lead.
Emphatic on the putback stuff.
Now, team's having a tough time containing him, attacking all the way there.
Here's Hero. The Cavaliers making the shot. And it's sent back by Allen.
That's a great swat. Jared Allen gets up there. Hard to escape his reach.
And we have to take another glance at that powerful rejection.
And an early swat like that can really set the tone. Now the shooters will be feeling his presence.
Caris LeVert's checked in for Cleveland. Heat also with a sub. Strus has checked in. Miami with the ball. Looking for the first basket of the game. Here's Lowry. And he uses the glass on the layup.
That's Kyle Lowry just putting it all on the line, just outworking guys to get in that close.
The pass to Mitchell. 1:58 left to play in the first. Goes up with it again. No good on that one. The Heat go the other way with it. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, their defense was just overrun. Couldn't match the intensity of the opponent, and it cost him.
Well, let's hope there isn't any carryover from that letdown in this one.
So both teams making some changes here. Here's LeVert. He picked up 12 points in their last win against the Clippers. Rubio, the pass to Love. 1:27 left in the first quarter. Takes the 13-footer 2 points, that one goes.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
There's 1:17 left here in the first quarter. And Greg, for Kevin Love, he feels like he's got a lot of years left in the league.
And Kevin, coming off the bench should lengthen the end of his career. He can thrive as a bench weapon with that green light, and he's got that light to let it fly with that shot.
Here's LeVert. Jimmy Butler making his last shot. Love with the screen for LeVert from deep. And there's the rebound by Dedmon. The Heat trail by 7. Here's Oladipo, and the Heat get another bucket right there.
Such a good scorer on the inside, finding just a bit of space, and then Oladipo confident to knock that one in.
We've got 33 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Now, here's Rubio. Defense right on him, and the layup's good off the glass.
Ricky Rubio playing super confident right now.
And you love seeing that great Mobile One drive a second time.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself.
Here's Vincent, covered by Rubio. Clock at 6. Pass to Buck. Over Wade. That one off the back iron and out.
Probably not the shot that was drawn up for that possession, but you can't pass it up, and you can't knock it down.
And so it's the Cleveland Cavaliers heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. They've been playing some inspired defense, giving up very few easy points. Right back after this break. And if you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. And from what we've seen from the Cavaliers, what do you guys see?
Hey, why take jump shots when you can get your points at the rim?
Yeah, that worked wonders for them in the quarter. We'll see what kind of adjustments get made.
So with Butler sitting on the bench, this is who Eric Spoelstra has on the floor. At the guard spots, Lowry and Hero. Martin is out there with Bam Adebayo. And it's Strus in at the 3 slot. Now here's Allen. He picked up 15 points in their last win against the Clippers.
And don't forget about the work he did on the boards. His rebounding was a huge help in that game.
Now Hero following the miss by Donovan Mitchell. Can't cash in from close range. Brent, how has size now affected the way the game is played?
Well, if I could just take a detour, Kevin, I would tell you it's skill that has affected the way the game has played. I mean, this has always been a tall man's game, and usually it's been dominated by the biggest guys, but that's not the case anymore. So you look at 6'4", the 6'7", guys who are skilled to shoot, pass, and dribble. That's what every team is looking for. And that's the way the modern NBA team, especially a championship caliber team, is made.
And the first one at the line is good.
And you figured once Gobert was traded, it was a matter of time before Mitchell was moved as well. You knew a team would jump at the chance to add him. And here we are now, a new start with a starring role for Donovan Mitchell.
Jetty Osman, he's checked in for LeVert. And Mitchell drops them both. Greg, an outstanding score. Donovan Mitchell takes it to another level in the playoffs, doesn't he?
And Kevin, how about all of his averages go up come playoff time? Spida is a guy who wants the limelight and, like other stars, takes on more of a load in the postseason.
Well, the catch and shoot is where Tyler Hero excels.
Garland, the pass to Mobley. From the line. And that one goes long. And so Adebayo will bring it up for the Miami Heat. 6-point game. Hero on the wing. And here's Adebayo. 17 points for him last game against the Hornets in Charlotte.
And he passed the ball so well in that game, keeping everybody involved even as he was racking up all those points.
Mitchell wide open, misses the three.
It's not his best night from the field, but looking for other ways and finding them so he can chip in.
Here's Hero. The Cavaliers pull it in. Allen's got his seventh rebound here tonight.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
And one thing that is special about Evan Mobley, made an immediate defensive impact as a rookie, something few big men are able to do.
As you said, very few rookie big men, Greg, can shape a defense like Mobley did.
Take a break.
Kind of reminds you of the impact Tim Duncan had with his defense. But Mobley can protect the rim and stay in front of guards on the perimeter. Boy, sky is the limit for him defensively.
And he makes the first.
And there's one area where the Cavs have been very good the past few seasons. That's the draft. They've made some terrific picks in terms of personnel.
Kane, he's checked in for the Heat. And both free throws good for Mobley. You're right, GA, they have, and the draft's been essential to the rebuild effort in Cleveland.
And they've been so smart about it. You look at the guys they brought in, Mobley, Garland, Sexton, they nailed just about every one of their selections.
Well, the D really getting away with one there. No one on him, and that's going to be good 9 out of 10 times.
It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Adebayo with a screen on Garland. Lowry. And it's sent back by Allen.
And they continue to control the glass.
From downtown, it's rebounded by Kyle Lowry. The Heat trail by 8. 3 minutes of action so far in the second quarter. Out to the wing. Here's Kane. And again, it's the Heat missing. Cleveland's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Mitchell with it. Picked up by Hero. Now, Garland. Really played well against the Clippers in his last outing. 6 to shoot. Puts it up from 17, and there's Mitchell. That's good on the assist by Allen.
I always wonder about those bigger guys, how much easier a read is like that, and Allen finds the open guy set up to shoot it.
And almost 4 minutes gone here in the second quarter of play. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Now a timeout called by Miami. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
So both teams changing it up here. Right now, let's check out the teams with the best free throw percentage. The Heat third.
You know, it's really a team-wide talent. You want to foul to stop layups, but against them, you're not saving much. They'll make you pay time and again.
closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. Butler finds Oladipo. Inside, here's Robinson. Good for the basket, starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
And really just unselfish basketball on the interior. That's the kind of pass a coach loves to see.
You know, Brent, when we talk about destination franchises, Miami has got to be in the conversation for being number one. Agree?
Well, Kevin, if it was December and I invited you to, let's say, South Beach for a dinner, would you come?
Are you kidding me? Of course.
Absolutely, you would. But beyond the weather, it's the culture there in Miami, and certainly it keeps attracting top-tier free agents. LeBron James, Jimmy Butler, Kyle Lowry. There's more to come.
First free throw is good.
And they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter.
Both free throws good from Love. GA, it wasn't long ago that the Cavs were an afterthought in the NBA.
Well, not anymore. I mean, Cleveland has a tremendous young roster. They play some of the toughest D in the NBA, and they're only going to get better in the years to come.
King, no luck.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
1:31 left to play here in the half. And stolen by Butler. Here's Vincent, covered by Rubio. Fades and shoots. Vincent misses.
And if that's the best look you can get on a possession, what a waste of a trip down the floor.
Yeah, see the coach? He's got that frown on his face. I think we know why. Not a high percentage look.
They get it back. Love. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2-for-2.
And Kevin Love still has a nose to get down there and collect offensive rebounds.
The Heat trail by 12. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Outside Butler. Oladipo outside to the paint. It's Butler that time on the assist by Oladipo.
Oladipo playing a couple years at point guard in Orlando when he started his career, showing off his passing ability there.
The Cavaliers leading by 10. Pass to Stevens. There's 31 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. The teardrop falls in.
When a player gets a feel for that floater, it can really make things tough on defenders. You're just not sure how to guard them and where your point of commitment is.
Miami's gone 1-of-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Oladipo outside. Six on the shot clock. Passes it to Vincent. Puts up a three. No good. And so it's the Cleveland Cavaliers up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. They've been playing some ferocious defense. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. From one Kevin to another, you guys were dominant in that first half and you have a big lead, but do you forget about that in the second half?
Oh, yeah. We got to treat like a 0-0 game. I know we're going to say in the locker room, we got to come out and win the third quarter. If we do that, we feel like we'll be okay. But like I said, this team is tough. We know they're capable of coming back.
Well, we'll see what happens, Kevin. Thanks. Now back to the other Kevin.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
And as we welcome you to halftime, no other way to say it, an abysmal start for the Miami Heat. And when a team is this in sync, it's almost like they're of one mind.
Yeah, it's like it's an invisible hand is guiding their actions.
Yeah, like by remote control.
All right, now it's getting a little weird. And now let's look back on that first half of play, one that has not been pretty for the Heat.
They really got to turn the intensity up in the second half. You look at their free throw differential between the teams, it's a big gap. They need to be more physical and start earning more fouls.
And that about wraps it up. And as the third quarter is about to begin, we go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Donovan Mitchell really making a difference here.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
Yeah, just way too easy out there, and I'm sure Coach is going to make that a priority at halftime.
The defensive pair in the post, Mobley and Allen. Darius Garland is out there with Mitchell, and it's Okoro in at the small forward. That's the five for Cleveland right now. And now the latest from our reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. Caris LeVert has become one of the game's best slashers. He says, honestly, I just go to the front of the rim and work on different spins. Getting more comfortable with both hands and finishing. Kyrie Irving did that when he was younger, and that's one of the ways he became a great finisher. Kevin, back to you.
He is a great finisher. David, thanks. He's studying the greats, and it's paying off. Here's Garland after Tyler Hero's bucket. For three, Mitchell. Jimmy Butler with the rebound. The Heat trail by 13.
Boy, a fierce competitor. Jimmy Butler puts his heart and soul into the game.
There are not a lot of opponents or players in this league that are going to outwork Jimmy Butler, and he does. He impacts the game in so many ways, and he's all about winning. Well, good job by Tyler just finding the open teammate and showing some good awareness.
And it's Mitchell with the ball for the Cleveland Cavaliers. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Fires the three. And they'll get another chance. Garland, the pass to Allen. For three, Mitchell drills it from outside. Mitchell's got 15.
And he's finally getting the feel from beyond. His second three of the half right there.
There's the pass to Adebayo. Outside, Hero. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. It's on Jared Allen.
Hero right now working himself into a lather, staying aggressive and drawing the defense's attention.
Well, we know how Tyler Hero's a bucket, but still lots of room for growth. Last season, the sixth man of the year winner. He really did struggle, though, in the postseason.
The first one falls. And, Greg, you look at the playoff shooting percentages for Hero, tailing off from his regular season numbers.
And, Kevin, that's not uncommon for a younger player, but the playoffs are what matters. And to be a star, that's when you've got to deliver.
Wade, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. Caris LeVert comes in for Isaac Okoro.
Well, when he gets into a groove at the free throw line, it doesn't just last for tonight. This might be 2 weeks, 2 months, something like that.
Garland feeling it out a little bit. Kicks it to Mitchell. Launches a three. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Garland. Garland's got three assists tonight. Here's Hero. He's got seven. Adebayo with a screen on Mitchell. There's Hero with a three. Sinks the triple. 10 points for him.
And how about that? Coming out to start the half, a perfect three of three.
Garland dishes to Mitchell. Allen trying to break free, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and two shots coming up.
And that's part of what Mitchell brings to the table, the willingness to operate on the perimeter or get in there and mix it up on the interior.
He's off on the first. Greg, we're seeing more fines recently for the language that players use with the media. Is that a concern?
I don't think it should be a concern, and I'm not kidding. The league's going to have standards of decorum. You're on TV. You got to keep it together. However, I think that as a society, we're a little more tolerant of certain words that are used in public.
And the second free throw, good. And, of course, one of the league's longest-tenured coaches, GA, is Eric Spoelstra. And he's having a Hall of Fame-level career.
And you look at the ground he broke when he was first hired. Not only young, Spo was the first Asian-American head coach in any of the four major North American sports leagues and worked his way up from video coordinator.
Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. Just two to shoot. Deadman's shot is off.
Yeah, and they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the tip. Their rebounding edge right now, massive.
Now, here's Garland. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Allen kicks to Mitchell. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good.
And you know what? He's shaking off the cold shooting performance from the first half.
Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Now, here's Strus. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game. Here's Adebayo. In close, he hits it. Adebayo's got 4 points this quarter.
Bam trying to expand his game a little bit as he's able to knock down the catch-and-shoot jumper.
The Cavaliers leading by 13. Garland, the pass to Allen. On the wing, Mitchell. Shoots over Strus. And there's Mitchell. That's good on the assist by Allen.
Pretty easy right now. Clear out. Give him some space. Let him get to work.
To the inside. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lowry. And checking out the numbers for Tyler Hero. The Cavaliers have gone 5 of 7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. Allen, a screen on Lowry. Pass to Allen. 1:29 left here in the third quarter. And here's Mitchell from the arc. And another three for Cleveland.
Well, he doesn't look satisfied with the lead right now. He wants more, and he looks like he's going to get it.
Timeout called, the Heat. Donovan Mitchell really making a difference here.
Not sure what the defense is thinking, or if they are. They continue to let him shoot. That is bad defense.
Robinson's checked in for Miami. Gabe Vincent comes in for Caleb Martin. There's 1:17 left in the third. Lowry with the ball. Pass to Strus. Six to shoot. And off target as he starts the game 0-for-1. Rubio taking his time here. Back to Mitchell. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by the Heat. Outside Lowry. Pass to Dedmon. Strus in the corner. Again, the miss by the Heat. The Cavaliers leading by 18. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Mitchell is double. And Rubio kicks to LeVert. Kicks it out to Love. That's good. And it's LeVert with the assist. Love's got 9 points.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. Cavaliers on top. They finish off the third quarter with a tremendous 17-7 run. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Rocket Mortgage Fieldhouse. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. On the court for the Heat, Adebayo is the big man with Butler slotting in at the four. At the guard spots, Lowry and Hero. And it's Strus in at the three.
Pretty much having the green light on the offensive end, Tyler Hero gets explosive to score.
And so Garland will bring it up for the Cavaliers. He dishes it to Mitchell. Back to Garland. Mitchell against Hero. That's good for Mitchell on the assist by Garland. Garland's got 4 assists in the game. Butler passes to Hero. Now Adebayo. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
The Cavaliers leading by 19 points. Garland, the pass to Love. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
This is what you get with Kevin Love. He can slide down to play the center position. And obviously, he's a great stretch four, so that's some flexibility.
And a look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Cavaliers.
Their accuracy in this one has just been on another level. I mean, the 3 ball keeps falling, and the defense just hasn't been able to run them off the line.
Well, we've also seen them being very aggressive down in the paint. All game long, they've been hunting down those inside points.
No good on that one. And the Cavaliers making a change here. Stevens has checked in. Martin's checked in for Miami. Good on the second free throw. And for a lot of up-and-coming teams, getting better defensively is the key to reaching, Greg, that next level. That being considered, what's the first step in that improvement?
A lot of times it's bringing in a great defender, like a Pat Beverly or an Andre Iguodala, a defensive anchor who also inspires his teammates to take that challenge.
Love with the screen for Garland. There's the drive. Over Adebayo. Here's Mobley. goes up and lays it nice and easy. And the Cavaliers lead by 20.
And a nice spark for their offense here in the second half. Now above 50% for the game.
And it's Isaac Okoro with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Allen's checked in for Kevin Love. And we've made our way through just over a minute and a half in this fourth quarter. Bounce pass, Butler. Shot clock at 5. Fires, high post. Hit the clock.
Oh. And how about Adebayo just getting up and getting athletic?
And great camera work showing up on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. The Cavaliers leading by 18. Here's Garland. Driving the lane. Lobbed up there for Allen. An emphatic LU jam.
You could put that ball just about anywhere for Jared Allen. Puts those long arms to great use.
We're in the fourth quarter here. Just under 2.5 minutes gone. And the Heat call time here. And the play-in tournament, Greg, is here to stay, but the terminology is somewhat in limbo. Is that going to be part of the playoffs?
You hear people say it's not the playoffs, it's the play-in. Maybe the term postseason should cover both the play-in and the playoff. Something to think about.
And now a moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, Donovan Mitchell.
Yeah, and his performance has been a jaw-dropper. It must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight, because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
The better he played, the more these fans got revved up. And that continued to play out over the course of his amazing performance. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. Butler kicks to Adebayo. Now the pass to Hero. Butler with the ball. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. Clock at 6. Lowry deciding where to go with it here. No good from outside. Got the defender off his feet with the pump fake, but couldn't knock it down. Okoro dishes to Mobley. And he banks in the layup. 8 points for Evan Mobley.
Okoro showing his ability to find an open teammate.
The leadership of the NBA Players Association, Greg, has said they support expansion. And two cities, which seem to be the leading candidates, Seattle and Las Vegas. What do you think?
Well, I love both. Had the good fortune of playing in both cities. And I'd love to see a team in my hometown, but It's bottom line, more teams means more jobs. And that's a sentiment I think most can get behind.
A nice shot by Mobley.
Assessing that possession right there, Garland waiting for the opening to find the man.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good.
And Hero, one of those guys you just rely on coming in and giving you that offensive pop. He does a lot of things for his team on that end of the floor.
And Hero drops them both. And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. Mobley outside. To the middle. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Greg, we know a lot of teams using former NBA officials now working as consultants to teach their players how the refs see the game. I guess always looking for that edge.
Yeah, Kevin, I think it's a great idea because philosophically, sometimes as the rules evolve, players got to learn how to evolve with them. So not getting the calls you might expect, also how you communicate with officials, I think all of that stuff plays a big role in just furthering that dynamic between the officials and the players.
Both free throws good for Mobley. And here's Hero. He'll bring it up for the Miami Heat. He kicks to Butler. Adebayo with a screen on Garland. Martin for three. Allen with the rebound. Allen's got 11 rebounds in the game. And here is Garland. Inside. It's Allen on the wing. Shot clock at 6. Here's LeVert. And another miss by Cleveland. Miami's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Cavaliers.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, an all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that. And man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And so checking out their record tonight, it'll mark win number 32 overall. And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Donovan Mitchell.
Well, those points he had tonight, all critical, all from energy and activity. He just never seemed to stop.
Okoro shot is off. And so here is Miami. Down low. And Adebayo throws it down.
Yeah, you try your best defensively to push Bam away from the rim. That's easier said than done.
We've got 33 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. LeVert sets a screen for Garland. Allen finds LeVert. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Tyler Hero picks one up.
Oh, tricky shot for LeVert. Defense is all over him, but he draws a foul on that attempt.
Two shots.
And the free throw drops for LeVert. And he makes the first, but misses the second. The wide open look here for Oladipo. No good from outside. Rubio outside. So we see the Cavaliers taking the win here. It was a tale of two teams tonight. One that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go. And once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Kevin, when you win a game like tonight, what kind of positive things are confirmed?
That we can fight through it and beat any team in the league if we're playing well. So for us to get this win here, you know, our sixth man is our crowd. They've been great. They packed the house tonight, and we got a big win against a team that's, you know, right up there with the top teams in the league.
You did it all together tonight, Kevin. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.